The first energy production process is called the Phosphagen System. It provides the first short, sharp burst of energy. During a 10-meter race, our muscle cells contain just enough ATPs to power a few steps. You see, our organic batteries, being so minuscule, only store one charge each, because they are too heavy for cells to store in large quantities. For example, you would need about 7 kilograms of ATP to fuel a 1-hour walk using your Phosphagen system, so your body only stores about 100 grams of ATP at any given moment. After those first few steps, our leg muscles will have depleted their limited supply of ATP, so they start using another molecule similar to ATP called creatine, which also binds to phosphates as creatine phosphate, or PCOR, and stores energy. Your creatine phosphate stores too are limited though, becoming about 60% depleted after 10 seconds of sprinting and fully exhausted after 30 seconds. But that first 100 to 200 meters where you relied on the Phosphagen and PCR systems gives your body the time it needs to fire up another energy recharging process that involves breaking down sugar. Sugar, a simple form of carbohydrate, can be used to recharge ATPs through a process called glycolysis, from glyco for sugar and lysis for breakdown. During glycolysis, enzymes cleave the sugar molecules in half, liberating the energy from its bonds to charge two ATPs. This approach doesn't require oxygen and is rapid enough to provide almost half the energy used during a 30-second sprint. But there's a catch. During glycolysis, the leftover halves of each sugar, molecules known as pyruvates, accumulate faster than cells can get rid of them. As pyruvates pile up, enzymes convert each pyruvate into a molecule called lactate, along with a hydrogen ion. And although lactate is harmless and is eventually used to recharge ATPs, those hydrogen ions make muscle cells increasingly acidic, causing fatigue, pain, and decreased function. Within about 30 seconds of sprinting, your legs will feel as if they are burning. It then takes a lengthy period of time to slowly neutralize the acid and shuttle the surplus lactate into the third long-term aerobic, or requiring oxygen, energy process. Oxygen is a necessity if you want to run for extended periods. Again, it all comes down to a question of efficiency. I had mentioned that during glycolysis, your body can yield 2 ATPs from a single molecule of sugar. This is fine for a short burst of energy, but sometimes your body needs to go longer, like running a marathon. Well, aerobic metabolism, where you use oxygen to burn a molecule of sugar, yields 18 times more ATP than glycolysis, so 36 ATPs for a single molecule of sugar. The trouble with aerobic metabolism is that it can't deliver energy quickly because it requires a long sequence of steps and an army of enzymes to function. These steps occur within specialized structures in your body's cells called mitochondria, which are capable of burning not only the pyruvates that come from sugar, but also fats, and in emergencies, proteins. So your aerobic energy system will kick in when you start exercising. But the energy it yields isn't available until you start getting into those longer distances. But the maximum level of energy that you can obtain through aerobic metabolism varies from person to person. We all have a limit. This is an important concept illustrated in the figure on screen and is termed maximal oxygen uptake, or VO2 max.